What's up, guys? I'm going to show you a quick tutorial on how to utilize your Twinmotion 3D models and create a 2D floor plan. And you may want to do this for a presentation of some sort, but I'm going to show you quickly on how I was able to achieve the look of a 2D floor plan in my Twinmotion 3D model. Alright, so let's get to the video. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna zoom out, okay? And we're gonna go to our library panel, and then we're gonna scroll down and go to tools, and then we're gonna go to section. And right here we got our section cube. So then we're going to drop our section cube there. All right, so now that we have our section cube activated, we can enable or disable it by clicking on this button, or we can also change the color, and we'll get a little further changing the color. But really what that does is it when you move your cube, your section cube over, it automatically cuts through the model itself. So it essentially creates a poche, and you can change the color of that poche if you want to. So you can, so you can kind of change the color of that poche if you want to, but we're gonna keep it black for now. You also can change the thickness of it, and you can also invert your section cube, and you have your clipping mask as well for geometry and point cloud and both. Alright, so because we're recreating a 2D floor plan, we're not gonna need a section this way. We're gonna actually move our section cube up above our 3D model, and then we're gonna hover on top of our 3D model, and we're just gonna kind of make sure that we're on top, and then we're gonna drag it down. So now we can see on top of our 3D model, right? And then after that, we're gonna go to this eye icon, and we're gonna go to views. So we will click on the house that shows the top of the floor plan, or top of the 3D model. And as you can see, it's kind of vertical. I do not want it to be vertical. We're gonna click on the icon, click on our views, and to get it a horizontal look, we're gonna go here to custom, and it automatically puts our 3D model horizontally, which is what I want. So now we're gonna create our image. We go here, we can add image, create image, and now we're ready to go. So now that we create our image, we're gonna kind of play around with some of the settings. So time of day is 30. Just kind of seeing some of the things that I want to do. Take away. Our HDRI, and kind of change the rotation to kind of see how far you want the sun to show inside your model. kind of play with our vignetting. Bring up our sharpness to 25. Go to our render settings. So right now we have our contrast set to 50%. Let's do 55. Our saturation goes up to 60. We're gonna put a color gradient on this one. We're gonna go to 10. And also for the filter, we're gonna do a light line light. So now we're gonna render using the path tracer on this one. So right now that's at medium. We're gonna change it to high. And we're gonna kick it up a notch. 24. Guys, if you're liking this video, please do not forget to hit the like button. Share, comment down below if you have any questions. Fireflies down. So right now we got the format at full HD. I'm gonna make it 4K. We're gonna hit tile rendering as well. And as you can see, it looks a little dark right up in here. Let's see if we can change that. Change it to our backdrop. And then we're gonna go. Okay, we're just going through the HDRI environments to kind of see some options here. It's actually looking pretty good with the option that we have. But I was kind of thinking something a little different. Let me do something real quick here. So this is the guy I want to go for. So we're gonna go with this guy and then we're gonna drag it over. There we go. All right, so now if you want to kind of, as you can see, it's a lot more lighter in some of the areas that were darker. And it's looking pretty good. We're gonna change the vignetting just to kind of give it a kind of a darker look around the edges. And guys, this is looking pretty good. Please do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe. All right, so the path tracer is still doing its thing. And if you're looking to follow along with me, this 3D model is on my website at renderreboot.com, and you can definitely download it for free right now. And Yeah, so this is how you accomplish your 2D floor plans for a presentation. All right, guys, and we'll be back with another one.